Hello, massage nurse. Today I'm going to be talking about reproductive pathologies. I'm going to be talking about menstrual syndrome, menstruation, menstrual cramps, endometriosis, ovarian cyst, and polycystic ovarian syndrome, and menopause. And I am going to tell you that for the first time, I'm really going to disagree with the book because I do not believe that menstruation and menopause are pathologies. I actually think that they're a very normal process of our reproductive years, and I do not think that they're pathologies. And I, especially for younger people, you know, they're very impressionable, and they might, I don't want to put in anybody's mind that menstruation is a negative thing or menopause is a negative thing. Actually, you know, they're both to be celebrated. So I just wanted to get that out of the way. I do not personally believe that they are pathologies. So let me start with premenstrual syndrome, also known as PMS, and that's a cluster of symptoms that occur 3 to 14 days before your onset of your cycle, menstruation cycle. There's different symptoms like weight gain, like bloating, breast tenderness, muscle and joint pain, emotional and behavioral, you know, releases. And one of the symptoms can also be headaches, and this is where you can really help your clients. You want to accommodate the massage, you know, to work their neck and shoulders and try to get them to relax. And like I said, this is 3 to 14 days before they start, you know, their menstrual cycle. So just accommodate to your client if they have a headache or if they just need a full body relaxing massage. So next will be menstruation. The menstruation is the sloughing off of the endometrial tissue for non-pregnancy. So if you don't get pregnant, then every month you slough off that endometrial lining. And to me, menstruation is a normal process, you know, and it's not a pathology. The onset of your first menstrual cycle, it's called menarche, and that the average age in the United States is 12 years old. So that's the average age. And so menarche is your first menstrual cycle, and it goes on for usually 50 years, you know, until you hit menopause. However, it's a normal, like I mentioned, it's a normal cycle. To me, it's not a pathology. So the next one will be menstrual cramps. Now here, you know, you really do get into a little bit of a pathology, because menstrual cramps are also known as dysmenorrhea, and it is the number one gynecological problem, you know, for women. And it usually happens on the onset of your menstrual cycle, day one or day two. One of the reasons is because you release prostaglandin, which is a hormone, and this hormone, facilitates uterine contractions, like when women are going to give birth. So that's why you feel the cramping, because it's cramping a little bit to slough off the endometrial lining that didn't, you know, that didn't, in other words, you didn't get pregnant, so it's sloughing off all that, you know, that uterine lining. So you might have contractions, you know, feeling, you know, cramping. And one of the things that you can do is, as a massage therapist, is put a warm, you know, a warm pad, preferably a moist heat, on their abdomen or their low back, because a lot of times it does hurt their low back. And another one would be rolled up towel that you can put underneath the breast when they go prone, or above their breast or between their breasts, because of the tenderness that they might feel. So just accommodate to your client to whatever their needs are for that day, whether it's premenstrual syndrome or, you know, menstrual cramps. Always want to make sure that you keep your client comfortable. And heat is one of the things that really helps with menstrual cramps. So next would be endometriosis, and that's the endometrial tissue outside of the uterus that gets response to hormonal changes, and it's local pain, it has inflammation. So you treat it again the same as a normal massage. If somebody comes in and they have endometriosis, you know, you want to accommodate the same way, stay away from deep pressure and, you know, in the pelvic area, apply moist heat if you can, keep them comfortable. If they can't lay down, prone because they're in pain. You prop them up sideline. Sideline, guys, is a great option, especially for somebody that's having, you know, a lot of pain or issues, swelling. So remember that. Sideline is great. So next would be ovarian cyst and polycystic ovarian syndrome, and they're different. The ovarian cyst is our fluid filled within the ovaries, and that's usually unilateral. It happens either on one side or the other side, and these little ovarian filled sacs, you know, that they hurt, they can be painful. And the polycystic ovarian syndrome, there are two or three times larger than the ovarian cyst, and they're usually bilateral on both sides, and they may cause a lot of thickness and scar tissue. And actually, the polycystic ovarian syndrome is the number one cause, one of the causes, and I think it is the number one cause for infertility, because it has so much scar tissue that you're not able, you know, to get pregnant. So again, most of these you accommodate to the client's need. You know, if they are having any pain, you want to keep them comfortable. And usually with polycystic ovarian syndrome, they do have pain because it's usually on both sides. So keep them comfortable, guys. Put them sideline and, you know, have pillows and, you know, try to just give them a full body relaxing massage, because massage will help all of them to release water retention for stress, for helping them with insomnia, with better sleep, you know, patterns. So massage is beneficial to all of them. Now, the last one would be menopause. I like to think of menopause, well, I used to think of it as men and menopause, like you pause from men. But, you know, to me, it's not a terrible thing to go through menopause. It's uncomfortable. I'm not going to deny that, you know, and it usually takes quite a few years. It's not an onset like one day, that's it, you're done. No, it's a process, just like in anything. You know, life is a process, just like from your onset of menarche when you were, let's say, 12 years old, you know, and now you're coming to the closure of that reproductive years. And it can also be celebrated, you know, because it's a different age, and it gives you so much freedom and so many other ways that it should be celebrated. Both of them, menarche and menopause, should be celebrated. I don't think of them as a negative thing. I don't think of them as pathologies. I'm sorry about that. So menopause is the cessation of your menstrual cycle, and you have to go 12 months without a menstrual cycle before your post-menopause, before that's it, you're in, you know, full-blown menopause. So perimenopause is before, prior to your menstrual cycle might become irregular. Some women have cycles that go 2 or 3 months without a menstrual cycle, or it might get closer together every 3 weeks, you know. So it depending on, you know, on whether you exercise, you know, stress makes it, you know, hormones are adjusting. So it depends on you and you alone, how you're going to go through menopause. And I think attitude is makes a big difference. You know, I'll be honest with you guys, when I went through it, you know, I was hot all the time, and it did fluctuate my moods a lot. And I would get angry at things that I would normally not get angry about. It's like, what the heck is wrong with me? Because I was usually would not get angry at certain things, you know. However, the average age here in the United States is 51. And perimenopause are the years before. Postmenopause is, that's it, you're done. And so menopause is an average of 10-year transition, with a few years before for perimenopause. And while you're, let's say that you go 6 months without a menstrual cycle and then it comes back again. Well, that's not postmenopause. Postmenopause is when you've gone 12 months without a menstrual cycle. And like I mentioned, to me, menstruation and menopause are to be celebrated for different reasons, and it's not a negative thing. One of the things with menopause that I will tell you is that, you know, women have hot flashes, and night sweats and hot flashes are two different things. However, it's very important for you to keep your room temperature cool, maybe have cool sheets, not blankets, and have a fan blowing in the room for women with menopause. I've had many women that get a hot flash, you know, when they're on the table. So I try to keep the fan blowing cool air. That really helps, because it, to me, when I used to get hot flashes, and I never got night sweats, you know, where you wake up drenched in the middle of the night, I never really got that. So I don't know what that was, that's like, but I did get the hot flashes. I was always hot, and when the room got hot and stuffy, I just wanted to run out. That's how I felt, like I just wanted to run out and get fresh air. So be aware of that, you know. The women's reproductive cycle throughout their years is amazing. This is what keeps generations going. You know, you pass on your genes when you have children, you pass on your genes for future generations. So it's a wonderful thing to be celebrated. And I, you know, I'm sorry that I disagree with the book, and some of you might disagree with me, and that's okay. I don't mind that. But actually, what I'm trying to teach is that we can disagree with a book or with me or with anybody. You know, do your own research, make up your own mind, but don't let anybody tell you, you know, like, hey, menstruation is a pathology. If, 'cause I, you know, I want you all to be able to make up your own mind about things, empower women, and especially empower young women, and especially empower young massage therapists. So until the next time, create a great day.